This is the solution to Wex 133. So to do this, we'll compute the average value. As a reminder, the formula is 1 over b minus a integral a to b of the function there, whatever the interval happens to be. And on this specific exercise, that'd make that 1 over 4 minus 1 integral 1 to 4, and then 16 w divided by 2w squared minus 1 dw. We'll do a substitution. So how about z is 2w squared minus 1, so dz is 4 w dw. Good. So then we don't really have 4w, we've got that 16w, so I'll just replace the w dw with dz over 4 is w dw, and now I'll change the limits. Z z evaluated at 1 is so we're using that z there. Z evaluated at 1, well, 2 times 1 squared is 2, and then subtract 1 is 1. And then z evaluated at 4. 4 squared is 16 times 2 is 32, subtract 1 is 31. Performing that substitution, that'd be a third, multiplied by integral 1 to 31. The 16 just hangs out, so that'd be 16. And then over z, and then w dw becomes dz over 4. So 16 over 4 is 4, and then that 4 can be factored out, so that it looks like 4 thirds, integral 1 to 31, and then it would look like 1 over z dz, so that's 4 thirds, logarithm, absolute value, z from 1 to 31, so 4 thirds times the logarithm. Well, the absolute value of 31 is just 31, and the absolute value of 1 is just 1, but the logarithm of 1 is 0, so the answer is 4 thirds logarithm 31. Because the logarithm of 1 is 0. For part B, alright, this is saying we want to compute, we have to evaluate an integral. The result will depend on a variable m, and then we want to solve an equation. All right, so the integral is It's an average value integral. So then it'll be 1 over m minus 0 integral 0 to m, and then 6x squared minus 5 dx. All right, so that's 1 over m multiplied by, so now the antiderivative of 6x is 2x cubed, and the antiderivative of 5 is 5x. This evaluated from x is 0 to x is m. So that'd be 1 over m multiplied by, plugging in m, that would just be 2 m cubed minus 5 m when you evaluated m and then subtract 0. Because when you plug in x to 0, all that stuff is 0. So this would be 1 over m multiplied by, now notice that there's a, that in the first place that 0 is, you know, it's out of the picture. And then all those terms have a common factor of m. So this looks like 1 over m and then multiplied by 2 m subtract 5 and then multiplied by m, factoring out that common m. oh, wait a second. Not too many of them. So this is 2m squared. Yeah. That's better. Almost left that out there. So now those m's cancel. So 2m squared subtract 5. So this is the average, okay, for a given m. And now the question is you know, which m's, if any, will give an average value of 13. So now what we want to do is now we want to solve 2m cubed minus 5 is equal to 13. Okay, well, if we add 5 to both sides, not 2m cubed, 2m squared. So if we add 5 to both sides, then we get 2m squared is 18, so m squared is 9, and so there's two possibilities to that. There's m is negative 3, and m is 3. So that's the answer to the question, but you know, you might wonder, you know, how do you interpret that? Well, what it means is that if you plot Q of x looks like this. So the 6, it's a quadratic with a positive leading coefficient, so it's a parabola that opens up. The 6 makes it go up quick, and then the 5 makes it shift down. So in the end, it's a parabola, you know, that opens up, and it kind of looks like this. And what these two are saying is that we want to compute the average value, and we want it to be 13. The average value to be 13, and we want it to be 13 between 0 and m. And because this is symmetric, if there's going to be a positive answer, then there'll also be a negative answer, and they look like this. So we could have one over here at, let's think about this for a second. I don't know if this Lagrange. Yeah, so if I draw the parabola first, it'll be easier. So what it's saying is that if we select x is negative 3, something like that, really, to make the picture look right, I need to draw the negative 3 a little further to the left. So this is going up, you know, quick. And I'll draw the negative 3 a little bit further to the left. So at negative 3, this would be, 9 times 6 is 54, and then minus 5 is 49. So it happens, you know, the intersection happens quite high. But what the drawing is saying is that the average value of this function from negative 3 to 0 would have height 13. If I could just draw it properly. But because the picture is symmetric, you'll also see the same result at positive 3. So if I make it go up very quickly now. From 0 to 3, compute the average value there, it'll be 13. Something like that. So that's the symmetry of the picture is why there's symmetric solutions.